Engine using the helicopters are called as the turboshaft engines. Turboshaft engine are basically the modification of a gas turbine engine, that is a turbojet engine. What we have over here is a gas turbine engine. In this gas turbine engine, you can see that this part is the basic gas turbine engine. We have got our compressor, combustion chamber, we have got our turbine, right? So till here, it's a normal working of a gas turbine engine. But what we do is we install one more turbine over here. This turbine is not mechanically connected to the entire engine. Hence, this turbine is called as the free turbine. Okay? In proper terminology, if you want to study, this will be called as the free power turbine, a DGCA question. So what free power turbine will do? When the air is going into this engine, it has been compressed and everything happens, right? The exhaust gases that are coming over here, they drive the turbine. Turbine in turn drives the generator. Okay. But the gases which are coming out from here, they still have got some amount of the energy left. This amount of the energy which is left can be used to drive this turbine. Okay. And then this turbine can be connected via gear to our helicopter main rotor, which can help the helicopter to fly. This forward part from here to here, okay, that is from the beginning of the inlet to the end of the first turbine, is called as a gas generator. As the name suggests, it is generating the gas. Whereas the free turbine to the backward part is called as the power section. Why it is called power section? Because it is developing the power, okay? To turn the transmission to a 90 degree, see here we are changing the angle, right? So when we are changing the angle to a 90 degree, we use a special type of a gear called as a bevel gear. These are the bevel gear. In a bevel gear, the transmission change take place at an angle. This is a DGCA question. What is the angle at which the transmission happened? That is 90 degree, but he will ask you what is the name of a gear. So you should be able to name it as a bevel gear. Now, the engine drive which is coming into the main gearbox here. Okay. So in the main, from the main gearbox, we take a drive which drives the main rotor gearbox. And this is a planetary gear arrangement. As we have seen in the previous video, that in a planetary gear, what happens? The main gear is rotating, and this is the rotor. This is the state. This is the outer rotor. This is your main rotor. Okay. So what will happen is it will transmit the RPM. Okay. We'll reduce the RPM and we'll pass it on to the rotor blade, and then the rotor blade will rotate. Here, what the important thing you have to understand here is that even the drive has to be transmitted to the tail rotor. This has to be done because when a helicopter rotor is rotating in a particular direction, if I don't give a tail rotor, this will cause the helicopter to rotate in the opposite direction of the direction of the rotation of the blades. So to counteract this torque, we have to install a rotor blade over here, that is called as a tail rotor. So when the tail rotor, the transmission is passed over here like this, okay? We can see that this is a tail rotor, the transmission is passed. Now this is a very long distance, correct here? And this will be rotating continuously. So if this part is continuously rotating, this can create a torsional force in this entire shaft. What can happen is this part and this part, they can have a torsional force, and that can twist and damage my tail drive. So to prevent it from damaging, what we have done is we have installed a flexible coupling. Okay. So in the beginning, there is a flexible coupling. This is connected to the engine. This is connected to the rotor drive. Okay. So this flexible coupling ensures that there is a smooth rotational motion and there is no damage because of this torsional force. As there is a longer distance, you also need to support it. So you will see that there are certain bearings on which the load of this rotor transmission is kept. Okay. You can see this is coupling. In the coupling, you can see in this flexible coupling, you can see that this outer part, okay, is the input flange. Whereas this is the output flange. Input flange is what it will be coming from, the drive will be coming from the engine. Output flange is what the drive is going into the tail rotor. And these two are connected. So they have a flexible connection. Okay. This ensures that there is no load coming onto the tail rotor drive. That's it for today. See you next time. Bye-bye. Take care.